This video is on the topic of the endocrine system and hormones. In order to understand the function of the endocrine system, it's important to first understand what a hormone is. A hormone is a chemical messenger. This means that they send signals around the body in order to bring about a response in a target organ. Hormones are made and released from specialized cells in organs called glands. These glands make up the endocrine system. When referring to hormones being released, we use the word secreted instead because it is more scientifically accurate. The endocrine system is made up of all of the glands that secrete hormones. This diagram shows some different examples of these glands. The pituitary gland is called the master gland because the hormones it secretes control a lot of the other glands in the endocrine system. It is positioned just below the brain, and an example of a hormone it secretes is ADH. The thyroid gland in the throat secretes many hormones, an example of which is thyroxine, which helps to control the rate of metabolism in the body. The pancreas has many jobs, such as releasing enzymes for digestion. But in addition to this, it can also make hormones. Insulin is an example, which helps to lower the amount of glucose in the blood. The adrenal glands sit on top of the kidneys and can secrete adrenaline, which helps to control our fight or flight response. The final glands that you need to know about are the glands that release reproductive hormones. The testes in males release testosterone, and the ovaries in females release estrogen. Both of these hormones control the secondary sexual characteristics that aren't present in a person from birth. Make sure you memorize the positions of these glands in the body, because you may be asked to label this diagram in an exam. The hormones are synthesized in the cells of the gland. On this diagram, the gland is represented by the yellow cells and the hormone, the green triangles. Once the hormones have been synthesized, they are secreted into the blood and travel through the circulatory system until they reach their target cells. The target cells have protein receptors on the outside that can bind to the hormone in a similar way to how enzymes and substrates bind in the lock and key model. When the hormone binds to the receptor on the target cell, it triggers chemical reactions in the target cells that brings about the required response. It is possible for one hormone to have lots of different target cells. For example, there are lots of different types of target cells that respond to the hormone adrenaline, because adrenaline causes lots of reactions in different parts of the body. Any cell that does not need to respond to the hormone is called a non-target cell and does not have any receptors that can bind to the hormone. A common question that can be asked in an exam is to compare the nervous and endocrine systems. They both have the similarities of sending signals around the body to help to regulate the conditions inside the body as part of homeostasis. They both trigger responses in the body from their signals. When comparing, we can also look at the differences between the two. For example, the nervous system is made up of nerves, the brain, and spinal cord, whereas the endocrine system is made of glands. The nervous system sends electrical impulses in the neurons, whereas the endocrine system sends chemical hormones in the blood. The nervous system sends signals much faster than the endocrine system, but the length of the effect from the nervous system is much shorter than the length of the effect from the endocrine system. Remember that you need to make sure to refer to both things together in order to gain the marks in an exam. Here is an example of a type of question you may get asked about this topic in an exam. You're being asked to fill in the gaps in the table to describe features of the endocrine system. Starting with the type of communication signal, we have hormones that spread messages within the endocrine system. The source of this signal are the endocrine glands. The targets are the cells with the receptor receptors for the hormones and the target organs. The response time is relatively slow, the range of the effect is widespread, and the duration of the response is a long duration. In summary, the endocrine system is made up of the glands of the human body, which secrete hormones. Some examples of these glands include the pituitary and thyroid glands, the pancreas, the adrenal glands, and the ovaries and testes. The hormones they secrete are chemical messengers that travel in the blood to specific target cells, where they bind to receptors and bring about a response. Don't forget to check out all our other fantastic revision resources here at Save My Exams.